Hello everybody and welcome back again to Let's Play Assassin's Creed Origins. So, I have a bunch of loose ends to tie up before I leave Memphis, for now anyway. And as I mentioned in the previous episode, I have been doing a little bit of off-camera work by picking up treasures and so on. I finished most of the question marks. We still have one over here and one over here. But for the most part, all that menial labor is done. So yeah, let's continue with some actual quests, and I guess we're going to do the one for the seer first. We delivered the amulets, so now we have to tell the seer that we did that and see what we're supposed to do next. And he's waiting in the boat for me. Okay, am I supposed to talk to you?
Have you delivered the amulets?
Yes. One arrived too late to protect its bearer.
Which?
The adventurer. He met a lonely end, bitten by a snake.
This is sad news. All the same, I consider your debt paid. A sacred island lies farther in the embrace of Mother Nile. Bring me there, and I will tear aside the curtain that shrouds your nightmares.
Okay, sounds like a deal.
Deliver. Tell me what you saw.
I saw what has lain behind my eyes every night for the past year. It begins with a sandstorm. I rise to my feet and walk a corridor of ruins, passing into the Hall of Judgment. There, a twin of myself places a black stone heart onto the scales of my heart. It is then that the god snake strikes, Apep, larger than a mountain, larger than reason.
Well,
a bow of light appears in my hand.
I should try to avoid the crocodiles. Too late. Okay, let's just try to outrun them and then maybe we can continue.
Let us begin again.
A bow of light appears in my hands. I fight the snake and win, though not without injury. Then I rise through dark, choking waters to surface among lotus flowers. I claim my lost heart from an altar and travel to the field of reeds. In the distance, I see my son. When I reach for him, he turns to ashes. He...
Thus is your true seeing unbound. Here,
oh, poor Bayek.
The sacred island awaits our coming.
He's really shaken by this. Okay, I wanted to wait until he finished talking before I reach my next objective. There we go. Oh no, there's a crocodile. Be careful. You're running right into it. Okay, speak to the seer. Seems that the crocodile's going to leave us alone.
Deliverer! Would you be free of the curse that plagues your sleep? There is a ritual that will banish it from your mind forever.
Yes. Do it then.
Go beneath the waters south of here and bring up the statue of Khnum from the sunken temple of Ramses. With this likeness of the great potter to hand, the ritual can be performed.
All right. I just have to find some sunken statue. I'm sure I can do that. It can be found beneath the Nile in the sunken temple of Ramses. Alright, let's see where exactly. I guess it's actually the one landmark over here that I haven't explored yet. Of course, there's a number of crocodiles in the vicinity. So maybe I should use my boat to get there. Or any boat, for that matter. I guess this one will do as well. Oh no, don't dive. Climb up, please. There we go. Alright, let's go. I mean, there are still a few ruins that are not submerged in the water, so I can use them to kill the crocodiles from safe position before I dive into the water. Sunken Temple of Ramses. There you go. Alright, looks like statues of Sobek. Now, let's see. Pretty sure I saw crocodiles in the vicinity. Alright, and there's the treasures. But the crocodiles might be a little bit too far away to shoot them with an arrow. Yeah, I don't think I can do that. Also, it looks like this is actually a hippo and not a crocodile. Okay, I hope the hippo is going to leave me alone while I dive into the water. Let's pick up all them treasures. Looks like we have another one over here. And a lot more all over this place, but where's my statue? Oh, the hippo is getting kind of close. I hope it's not going to notice me down here. Alright, there we go.
I will bring it back to the seer.
Let's head back to safe place. And let's get out of here before the hippo gets too close. Alright. We made it. So now, back to the seer it is. Alright, I think I'm already at land. So, let's start this ritual.
Here is the statue.
Hnum, sculptor of children. He will battle Apep in your place.
That's great.
This ritual needs your mind's strength. Sit by my side and meditate as I speak with the gods. Grow, O light. Come forth, O light. Rise, O light, ascend, O light.
Use the dawn and dusk skill beside the seer to make the time speed forward and initiate the ritual.
Remove yourself from his eyes. O god of seeing, bring in the light to him. O Apep, who coils in the abyss, be turned aside, devoid of moisture. Come forth from the stream. As your sail bends to yesterday, accept him as a passenger on your divine ship. Hnum, stand beside him and be his champion.
All right, I wanted to listen to his chant, but now let's meditate and perform the ritual. Oh, he's gone.
The seer is gone. How did he leave the island?
I have no idea. He certainly didn't use the boat we came here with. And now the quest is just over. How strange. How very, very strange. Okay, well, I hope he's fine and wasn't eaten by a crocodile. But I mean, the crocodile would presumably also eat Bayek and not just the seer, right? Speaking of which, maybe I wanna kill the crocodile before I leave this place. I hope you haven't eaten the seer. Or maybe he's just magical. Oh, we have another one over here. Alright. Kill you next. Alright, looks like this is all of them. Right, well, that was interesting. Let's hope it's going to work. But, you know, it may as well work. I mean, this is a psychological problem, and if Bayek believes that it's working and that Knum is now fighting in his place, then, you know, the psychological effect of it might be that he's not having these dreams anymore. But, okay, let's head back into the harbor, and let's try to avoid this crocodile over here. Let's just dismount on this side. Alright, I guess that's this quest done. Not sure if there's going to be a follow-up where we can find out what happened to the seer. Now, I have actually reached level 30 now, so maybe I do want to continue this quest before I leave this place. Yeah, let's do this. I'll head over there, and I'll bring you back once I've arrived, because this is a little bit further away. Alright, apparently our quest is inside this little house, but I think before I'm going to start this quest, I will skip until morning, so we have a bit of daylight for this quest. And now let's check out what's going on here. Got a bunch of kids. Oh no, what happened here?
Ugly to kill in front of the little ones. What happened here?
In Nebu? Medu?
Well, maybe she can tell me.
Who was he?
Nef. The children called him father. This is his house. This is his house!
You are injured.
I don't give a shit. The Roman hag who did this leaves by boat for Alexandria today. Help me feed her to the crocodiles one piece at a time.
I can go alone. No need for you to bloody yourself, father.
It has to be me!
Is your need worth leaving the children unprotected?
Destroy her name, Bayek of Siwa.
All right.
I need to move quickly.
I will do that.
This monster will flee Memphis.
Okay, I gotta move quickly. Let's see, maybe I can fast travel there? Oh, it's all the way over here. Well, I guess I will do this, especially since I was specifically told to be quick about it. I'm not sure if this really would make a difference.
So you can find a ship with colored sails faster than I can.
Let's see. Oh, we got a ship over here. It's gotta be it, right? Let's find as a boat if we can. Of course, now there's no boat anywhere to be found. But I mean, there's this one guy who always comes to your help when you're in the water, right? So hopefully he will come this time too, because I'm not sure if I could catch up with a boat when I'm swimming. Well, I guess I do catch up a little bit. But it would be faster. Yep, there we go.
Nice.
This time I actually need your help. My ship is traveling on the Nile between Memphis and Alexandria. Alright. Let's approach from behind. And I'll swim the last few meters in the water. Now, let's see how many people are on this boat. Oh, quite a few actually, but I think it's going to be fine. Four of them as far as I can tell.
They will attack on sight here.
But I would say that I'm in a pretty good position. I can't headshot these guys. I can headshot him, however.
Alright.
Good. Thanks to my guided arrow.
Alarm! Over Nadia!
On my way!
Sure, this guy is well.
Who is shooting?
Stay alert. Barney.
They haven't.
I doubt these renegades to work out.
They haven't fought me yet up here.
We are ready for anything.
Oh, there's my target.
Shit, what's going on?
Hey, what?
Ah, now they found me. Alright. Let's make sure we kill at least one of them.
Dead!
And now I'm just going down.
How much longer?
Get rid of the remaining guy.
I see you!
No! Out! Out!
Alright. Oh, I set myself on fire. Sometimes the biggest danger to Bayek is Bayek himself. Oh, my clumsiness with the controls. And, okay, it looks like she actually got poisoned by the guy. Alright, well, let's confirm the kill.
Kawit has her vengeance now. I hope it quiets her heart.
That was actually easier than I thought. Anyway, let's have a quick look around to see if there's anything on this boat that I want to take with me. I mean, it seems that there's something below me. But how do I get there? That's rather strange. Is there like an opening I can smash open? It doesn't look like it. Or is it just something that's below the boat? I don't know. But it intrigues me. Let's maybe check out the boat from below. No, it's quite obviously inside the boat. So, how do I get inside the boat? There doesn't seem to be any way to actually go on the deck. Like opening the hatch or whatever. Oh well, I don't know. I don't know, maybe it's not that valuable anyway. But, okay, is that all I had to do? Or do I have to return to Kawit? No, it doesn't look like it. Alright, so, I guess that's all the quests that are available. We still have one quest to finish, which is Timotep Song. I have collected all the ingredients. So now I have to meet with that, I don't know, she was a servant probably. And we're going to leave Memphis towards the pyramids, I'm going to assume. And I can already see a bunch of quests over here. Speaking of which, where exactly is my next target? Okay. My next target is going to be all the way over here, which means going to Sakara next might be a good choice. It's also like the next gnome in terms of level. So Sakara, and then we go to Fayum Oasis, and then circle around back to Memphis probably. And then we still have all these very high level deserts at the outskirts. But I mean, they're deserts. How much stuff can there be inside deserts, right? Okay, I guess I will fast travel to the next location, which would be this one. And we're going to meet up with that woman, and we're going to leave Memphis for now. Alright, we are approaching our target. And yes, I have two flamingo tongues and two heron feathers. Now, the flamingo tongues weren't that difficult to find. The heron feathers slightly more difficult because sometimes it's hard to distinguish the herons from the ibises. So I killed a number of ibises before I actually found enough herons. But alright, let's talk to her.
I found what you need, Tamhotep.
The seer spoke truth when he named you deliverer.
My ritual must be performed in the moon shadow at the base of the pyramid of Djoser.
Okay.
Will you guard me and my maid until it is done? There may be dangers on the road as well.
Gladly.
Then let us ride to the pyramid and wait until the night unfurls in splendor.
Let's do it. I wanted to visit the pyramids anyway.
Where?
Are we going to use, like, these
This is uncertain country. Why not bring more guards?
My ritual must remain private.
Is that also why we travel off the main road?
Yes, it is less safe but more secret.
Okay.
The lack of a son lowers my husband in the esteem of the people. And if they knew of the babes I have lost, his ability to compel the gods would be called into question. There are whispers against him already. My troubles bring shame to him and to me.
Nebet, it is not your fault.
Hush, Mara. I know you mean to be kind, but the scrolls are clear. The woman is the carrier of the child Sex.
I do not believe that, Nebet.
Well, she's right.
Mara, we have had this conversation before. Let us be quiet now, in case our voices carry to unfriendly ears.
Good idea.
But of course, she has no way of knowing scientifically that it's not the woman's fault.
Now! I will find you! Got you!
Well, Abani, we already have some bandits here. All right. Let's see if I can just kill them without dismounting.
There! Hip!
It's actually not that difficult. Wonder what happens if I use my special attack while mounted. It doesn't really seem to do that much, though, so probably shouldn't be doing that. Finish off this guy over here. And yeah, I think using your overpower while on horse or camelback is just wasting it for the most part. And finally, let's kill the shield guy. Alright. That seems to be all. And I hope the ladies are still safe. Okay, they're still fine. And my camel is full of blood. Hope it's not the camel's blood. And there we go. Pyramid of Djoser. It does look small compared to the...
We are here.
Great pyramid.
My sword stands between your ritual and any who threaten it.
Ptah's blessing on you.
Oh, we have meteorites? That's great. But we have to focus on the ritual now. And since it has to be performed during the night, I guess I will have to meditate again. Because it's currently still kinda early. I mean, the sun has to be somewhere in that direction, judging from the shadows. So it's still mostly in the east. So I guess I will have to... Oh, it's just going to cut to...
Every morning of my childhood, my father and I spoke the prayer of the Medjay, a promise to those in need. I am a Medjay. I am a feather in the eagle's wing, a living dagger plunged from the sky into the heart of chaos. I am a truth unknown, a scabbard unfilled, a son of the Nile, and a defender of the people. You cannot kill me, for I walk among the dead. Come forth by day, and I will guide you home. My son should have learned this prayer from me.
Well, it was not meant to be. And okay, quest completed. And for some reason, now I'm on a horse and not a camel anymore. And it's not even my horse, it's just a random horse. But okay, apparently they successfully finished the ritual, so hopefully the child will be fine now. And I guess we can use this opportunity to explore this place a little bit. Specifically the pyramid itself. Okay, this is where they performed the ritual. Let's see if I can still talk to them, if they are still here. It looks like they're still around. Alright, let's see. Can I talk to you? Are you alright?
I will always remember how you helped me.
Okay. I hope you will be safe even if I move on my own now. And you will be able to make it back safely. And I wish you luck with your child, and I hope it's going to be a boy. For your sake. Okay, now, let's send out Senyu to see what we have around here. Okay, there's certainly a treasure somewhere. And there's a viewpoint on top of the pyramid. But again, I feel that this has to be seen during the day, so let's skip again. So we have some better light. There we go. That's much better. Alright, I guess I'll start by climbing the pyramid and then I guess we will have to find a way inside. Of course, as far as I know, this pyramid doesn't really have an inside. This is basically just massive stone and all the important parts are basically below it. But anyway, let's climb up first. Luckily, there's always a few stones missing, just enough to be able to climb the walls. And here we go! All the way on top of it. Oh, and this pyramid looks kind of wonky because of all the mirage effects. And we can see the pyramids of Gizeh. And we can see the sunrise in the east. How beautiful. Let's synchronize. Well, now that you're on top of it, it actually looks a lot taller than before. It looks a lot more impressive than initially. And like I said, when this was first built, it must have been pretty impressive for the people because nothing like that had been built before around here, so, you know, it was quite the achievement. Alright, so, the question is there any way to get to that treasure? Ooh, there's some random high-level guy. There's a lot of treasures in this pyramid. I mean, you would think that there's also like an entrance somewhere. I mean, this over here could be an entrance. And we have like a landmark over here. Sure, let's check out this place over here. Obviously, I can't just leap of faith down here, so I have to make a number of big jumps. I'm going to assume that this is like the temple belonging to the pyramid. Alright, this does look like it could be a way inside. Here we go! Tomb of Djoser. Yep, and as I suspected, it's basically going to be all underground. The pyramid is basically just a structure that is built above the tomb. Well, I can already see some stuff. Oh, I have to move around blocks again. Yeah, I think this is something I have to move as well. What do we got here? So that we may never again suffer the floods that brought the famine, the merchant Hanno has placed his grain sacks here. It is enough to make 100 loaves of 20 pefsu bread or 10 jugs of 4 pefsu malt date beer. Okay, apparently the Egyptians used dates to make beer. I didn't know that. I learned something new today. Alright, I guess we're going to start by moving around this block. I mean, it's not really a block, it's more like a small wall. And deeper into the tomb we go. I'm not sure how realistic this representation of the tomb is. I feel that it might be a little bit too big, but I'm honestly not familiar with the exact layout of the Djoser tomb. Anyway, Imhotep, the one who comes in peace, Chancellor of the King of Egypt, Doctor first in line after the King of Upper Egypt, Administrator of the Great Palace, Hereditary Nobleman, High Priest of Heliopolis, Builder, Chief Carpenter, Chief Sculptor, and the Maker of Vases in Chief, honored in death as in life. Okay, he's a guy who presumably built the pyramid, as in, you know, the architect. And as you can see, he also was like a doctor and a sculptor and a carpenter and a builder. So, you know, those were simpler times where people could be universalists in almost all of the important crafts and sciences. Doesn't really happen today that like that anymore. People are obviously a lot more specialized. Okay, there's an opening over here. But first, let's make sure we have completely looted this place. Now, let's open up this cracked wall. Ooh, this looks nice. Okay, there's something behind it, but I can just... Oh no, I'm going to set myself on fire again. Oh, and there was a snake inside. But I killed the snake with a fire. That was a happy accident. Alright. Yeah, I think these actually may be like original. They seem familiar. Okay. Okay, we can now maybe move this. No, it's blocked from the other side, so. Moment, I can't do anything about this. In that case, let's move on. I'm seeing a lot of quest marks over here and more cracked walls. Okay, let's destroy this one too. Okay, here we go. That is the ancient tablet, right? Nice. Then His Majesty of King of the Then His Majesty the King of Upper and Lower Egypt, Khufu, said, "Let an offering be made of 1,000 loaves of bread, 100 jars of beer, 1 ox and 2 balls of incense to the King of Upper and Lower Egypt, Djoser. Justified, and let there be given 1 cake, 1 jug of beer, a large portion of meat and 1 ball of incense to the chief lector priest as I have seen an example of his learning." Alright. Pani Khufu got inspired by Djoser to build his pyramid. Huh? Anyway, let's interact with the tablet, which means I should
ancient
have
writing
a few
from the old kingdom.
Skill points open, and I need to decide what to do with them. But doesn't have to be right now. Yeah, there's definitely more stuff going on over here. Destroy a few more walls. And His Radiance tasked Imhotep to build him a home for the afterlife. And Imhotep said, it shall represent your splendor and endure the ages as reminder of your greatness. He took 20,000 men to this place and said, Thoth sent me a vision, and here we shall build a mastaba greater than all the other mastabas. That's basically what they did, by building a few of them on top of each other. And the people said, we offer everything you need in honor to honor our great father. Alright. Well, so far I can't make it inside this place, I think. This is quite the maze. So how do I get inside that chamber? Let's see. Okay, there's something over here. Son of Horus, ruler of all, representative of the gods, builder of temples and culture, beloved father of our people, Jodha Netcherike. Alright, just a little shrine in here. But there's more. I can see it. I can see it, but I can't get there. Yeah, there's like, I think, an opening on that side. So I may have to backtrack for now and see if I can find a different way around here. I mean, I can't, like, climb this over here. Also, there's something I can interact with on this side. Or is it just the statue? Probably just a statue. Alright, well, in that case, I guess I'll gotta go back. These are all just dead ends. Oh, hang on a second. This is maybe not a dead end. Aha! Aha! There's more going on here. Alright. Can go through here. And we can maybe move this thing now. Alright. Let's see. Where will this lead us? Oh, we are back at the entrance. Okay. Okay. But I mean, I believe there were like more corridors that I haven't really checked out yet. Let's go down again. I totally didn't see this opening. I uncovered it by accident. Not a happy accident. Alright. But yeah, there's definitely more stuff going on down here. So, let's see if we can at least find that stuff. Alright, this is something we can move. And there's like another locked room that I can't seem to enter. Nope. Can't smash this one open. So let's check out this passage first. Okay, at least this treasure I can pick up. Yeah. I should probably start looking for openings that are above me, because those are always very hard to miss. So again, there's at least two rooms that I haven't really been able to enter so far. So I should always check the ceiling for openings. This is not an opening. Well, where did I come from? I think I came from up here. Okay, now I'm back in this place. Yep, there's definitely more going on that I haven't fully uncovered yet. I don't know, can I climb these walls? This thing over here looks ominous, but doesn't look like I can actually climb up there. Yeah, Senyu isn't going to help me with this either. I believe I have to destroy whatever's on the other side of this. I don't know if I can maybe shoot arrows at it. Look at that. Look at that. That's actually kinda neat. Now I get to loot this treasure, at least. So, that's only one room that I still have to uncover. Sure, let's head back for now. And let's try to find that room again. I'm not entirely certain which direction I have to go for this one. I think this is just back out. Yeah, it's gotta be somewhere below me. Right. It's over here. Now, let's see. Can I see any sort of opening? It looks like I might be able to enter this from, like, the opposite side. I'm just going to smash all the vases and see if they're maybe hiding a secret passage. There's something over here. There we go. Alright. Let's pick up all of this as well. Oh, great and glorious Khnum, I, your humble servant Djoser, offer this votive to you, that you may smile upon us and end the 7 years of famine afflicting our lands. Alright. I hope you were successful. Yeah, I think I've found more or less everything in here now. So, I guess I will try to find my way out of here now. And in the next episode we will probably look at the other pyramids and see what kind of quests we have in this area. The next target is in a different gnome, so I will probably stay a while in this one to finish off a few side missions first. But yeah, for now, let's call it a day, as usual. Thank you for watching, and see you again next time.